Hello and welcome to another episode of the Drop Time Hour, a special lunchtime edition. So this is at 12:45 in the EST, 12:45 p.m. Or lunch hour here at the workplace. I'm going to eat lunch. Well, for lunch, I'm going to have a fake chicken stir fry over some leftover rice. Well, the fake chicken stir fry is also leftover, so I ate for dinner last night. It was me and my lovely wife. So I'm going to enjoy that. I'm also going to take my dog out so he can get some exercise, and then I'm going to go back to work. Well, sometimes, you know, so this is episode 3A. Sometimes you have to just do an episode in the middle of the day because you got a lot on your mind, and that's why you have your own internet talk show, because you are kind of in charge of how many times you can speak to my audience, in this case, my fans. I got a few emails last time about the peeing project, and just wanted to clarify a few things. So I did figure out that I think the word I was looking for was vial. So, okay, so included with the deluxe version will be a vial of urine. So, a vial attached to a necklace. So, I guess is the proper term for that. You can picture it, I think. You know, I don't know what the going rate, if I bought vials in bulk on the internet, what's the going rate for vials that are then also easily attached to a necklace. So I don't know if there's on eBay, if I can buy glass vials in bulk, or if I have to go to some other website or some other outlet. But I would appreciate very much so if you are a listener and you have any ideas or opinions on that. Moving right along, working on a few other projects. I really want to start making more visual art. I've been contemplating the idea of going back to school, and I think that I need to really kind of try and beef up my visual art, collection, my personal made collection of art that I could put in a portfolio, because if I apply to a master's program, I don't think that it looks very good right now, and I'm not sure if they would catch the connection between what I do in other arenas of art and poetry and music, etc., that kind of stuff, as it pertains to getting into a MFA program. The end game of that would be, I'm 31, so I'm no spring chicken, but the end game there would be to eventually secure a job as a teacher, because I feel you probably get paid better than I get paid now, as a college art professor. And then, so it'd be basically, you know, I'm doing things that I like, and I have a crippling social anxiety and fear of public speaking, which I'd have to get over in the process there, but I guess that's always, I think it's good to try and confront your fears, so you would then, but then I would, I like all the perks of being in that field, the vacation time and benefits and whatnot, being, I'm not gonna, you know, that's obviously why you do it, and then just the ability to be in a field that you're inspired by, and I am in a lot of ways more inspired, even though I am a writer and a musician and the most prolific musician of all time. I still consider myself more as an artist in the terms of just what that, the very vaguest definition one could think about, just by saying I'm an artist. So that typically falls back on painting and visual things. Not that I, to be honest, I might spend the least amount of all my free creative time on creating just visual art, and I really am kind of stuck in a, you could call it an assemblage, Joseph Cornell, Robert Rauschenberg, being heavy influences, and have informed my work probably the most, and I can't seem to break free from that, and it's a bit of a crutch. And but work that I've tried to do that is not digital art, but just strictly with my hands and glue and paint and paper and canvas and collage and any type of thing like that, has always kind of gone back to that style. So I'm just trying to embrace that in as many different ways as possible. And the bottom line is really that I have to just get going more with that, with the making the visual art with my hands, and not not spending too much time on the computer and getting lost on the internet, thinking that I'm that. Then that's really my calling. Maybe not. Maybe I really have to just concentrate on making pieces and getting my own gallery representation, or maybe a gallery show, one-man show at a gallery or a coffee shop in town. I think those are really the same thing in the end, because I think if it's good, the public wants it, then the public is going to get it. So you got to who your audience is. And it's always a learning process. But okay, and that's basically all the time we have left for this, again, a special lunchtime episode. We'll be back later in the day for a second episode of my talk show, the Vernon Howells Driving Talk. And we're going to talk time, and going to have some lunch now, and be back in the afternoon. See ya.